Am I audible and visible to everyone?
हाँ मैम
Okay, so I'm starting. ठीक है? So we were discussing about the ethical issues in finance. So as we all know that how important finance is. Finance as a subject as well as a department, finance plays a very important role. We all are aware of means finance is the base of any company. So if there's any manipulation or mismanagement in means any issues with the finance part. The funding part, which forms the most important part for any organization. If there's any ethical issues in dealing with the finance, then it will have a very negative impact, or it will create a chaos in the entire organization. It may also leads to a very negative impact, negative long-term impact on the entire organization as well, right? We all know that. So now, because financial statement here, when we are talking about finance. I will not be able to look after the each and every aspect of the accounting. I'm talking about the finance. So normally, as an investor, as a promoter, or as an entrepreneur, as a board of director, or whatever position I'm dealing with, I have to be very specific that my company is following an ethical management system, an ethical management system in terms of financial management. Now, finance, when we talk about finance, it is actually the funding part. We are getting this finance not only means when we normally refer to finance and to a company type of organization. When we refer to a company type of organization, so in a company form of organization, the money invested is from different people. Different peoples are investing in a company. So the company management should take care of the fund invested there. So now, because it means in a company form of organization, many people are investing. So the stakeholders are many, the shareholders are there, and as a company, you will be responsible towards the stakeholders, shareholders, investors, owners, promoters of the business, as well as the employee, staff, the government, the creditors, and so many stakeholders are associated with an organization. So it is all the way very important that we should take care while dealing with the financial aspect. So an ethical mechanism has to be there in terms of effective financial management in any organization. See, one such specialized field is management accounting. Now, management accounting is a specialized field. It will give a basic figure or basic accounting information to the management concern for specific decision making. So it means management accounting is not a routine accounting. It is also a language of business, but accounting is a language of business and it states simply what you are accounted for. So it's simply a hisab rakhna. Accounting is simply hisab rakhna. And management accounting is a specialized field of knowledge or specialized field which simply state that I have to provide accounting or financial information to the concerned management for effective and efficient decision making. That means if a company is proposing to invest in some proposals or invest in or disinvestment from some proposal, then the company must need the management aspect of the accounting. It will not require all the each and every accounting figures and all. कंपनी वो सारे अकाउंटिंग फिगर्स लेके कुछ नहीं कर सकता. एक मैनेजमेंट अगर एक प्रपोजल को अप्रेस करिए वेदर टू इन्वेस्ट और डिस इन्वेस्ट फ्रॉम द सेम, फर्दर इन्वेस्टमेंट करना है, डिस इन्वेस्टमेंट करना है, वॉट एवर कैन बी द क्राइटेरिया, देन एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट दैट वी थिंक फ्रॉम द मैनेजमेंट पर्सपेक्टिव कि मैनेजमेंट को क्या चाहिए. तो एज अ अकाउंट्स और फाइनेंस प्रोफेशनल वी हैव टू कंसिडर इट फ्रॉम अ मैनेजमेंट पर्सपेक्टिव कि मैनेजमेंट को क्या चाहिए. सो दैट अकाउंटिंग और दैट प्रॉपर रिपोर्टिंग इज कॉल्ड मैनेजमेंट अकाउंटिंग. सो नॉर्मली फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट, सो वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट. सो फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट, what do you mean by financial statement? It is simply the statement which shows the entire details of the income generated, the revenue generated, the expenditure incurred, the balance sheet, the director's report, and so many things compiled together to form a financial statement. Financial statement shows the companies in and out throughout the year, and it is a very important statement which will convey the company's standing at a particular point of time. It is with the help of the financial statement any investor can decide whether I should invest in a company or I should not. See, suppose if I have to invest in a company, if I have to invest in a company like ITC or Tata Power, then what will I think or what will I look for? What are the options that I have to look after? Means how will I invest? I will just see the financial statement because there are other literatures also available about the company's proposals and all. But normally what will I do? I will just go through the financial statements available. I will look into the financial statements and then I will take a decision. Now, if that financial statements itself, there's certain manipulation or misrepresentation in that financial statement, then it will create a, means it will give me, it will portray me a negative impact. The wrong information is conveyed to me, and according to the wrong information, definitely I will invest into the company and I will bear the loss. So it is all about the financial statement, how the financial statements are prepared. Because all the manipulation or the ethical concern are there only. So it is very important given here at the step that management should take to ensure true, fair and reliable management account. So it is now very important that the soundness, means we all know that the entire, means how management is effective, how much a management is effective in dealing with the with this ethical concern and financial aspect, it all depends on the reliability of the financial information. So there are a few steps that has been given. Given there are the steps that management should take care to ensure true, fair and reliable management accounts. Fine. Determine the key elements of the business like the firm's objective and see how they are defined and measured. So first thing is we have to determine the key elements of business. Means what are the key elements of the business? What is the objectives of the firm? And see how they are defined and measured. So it is very important when before I go into this accounting and financial management, because normally misinterpretation is done according to industry basis. Means the people in the financial part who are working in the finance, they all know, means what are the in and outs of a company. Means it is industry specific as well. Means the representation of the financial statements, it all depends on the industry to industry basis as well. So before I means as a company manager, as a company promoter, I need to understand my company's objective. So determine the key elements of the business like the objectives of the firm and see how they are defined and measured. So first thing is I should always understand the objective, the firm's objective. What is the firm's objective? According to the firm's objective only, means we have to understand that's how these are defined, how they are measured, everything. Make sure that funds are allocated to different activities based on their importance. So make sure that these funds are allocated to different activities based on their importance. So first thing is, what is my business objective? How do I define it? Means objectives has to be specific, that this is my objective, my 1 crore is my target, which segment, from which segment I'll generate this target. This has to be specific, that this is objectives, objective for 6 months, objective for next 1 year. This is objective. Now objective, I have to see it, means how they are defined and measured. Means only definition will not work, defined and measured. Then I have to ensure that the funds are allocated to different activity. This is the most important activity of any financial managers. Financial management deals with this only, that is procurement of fund and allocation of fund. So I have to ensure that the fund that are so collected needs to be means allocated to the activities of, according to the importance. Frame rules that have a positive impact on business activities. It is important to ensure that each project or department is allotted its fair share of fund and that the projected earnings of the project or the departments are in accordance with the funds allocated to it. See, what happened is that we have to frame the rules for effectiveness. It should generate a positive impact on all the business activity. That means I should not allocate funding on a basis means as per parity basis or as per affordability method. It should be the department should be allotted with the funds as per the fair price basis or fair share of fund. Companies should ensure that each project or department is allocated share price of fund. Fine. In such case, even if the work in the project proceeds smoothly, the project may not achieve the expected earning. This can affect the employee. See, at times a project may be under allotted. sometime you will find that a project is under allotted. So definitely if a project is under allotted, that then it cannot contribute. Even if it is worth of contributing, it may not be able to contribute to the overall earning. This can affect the employee's performance related pay, thus leading further on employee demotivation. See, everything depends on your employee, and if employees are demotivated, then again there will be an ethical issues that will be coming up. Because if employees are not motivated, they are not getting their, means if my entire project is under allotted, the proper allotment of fund is not done, then I will not be able to work as per my potential, as per my project's potential, I'm not being able to give my performance. So definitely my project related or performance related pay will get affected. Now this is the pay, one of the most important thing why people are working. If my pay is hampered or it's disturbed by any way, then it will affect the demotivation. And demotivation is one such very important factor for your lowering down of morale, or rather we can say the coming up of this different type of ethical dilemmas and all, right? Trust can be ensured by applying appropriate and consistent rules in management accounts. All the departments should follow consistent rules related to financial calculations to achieving a coherent pictures of the business. This methods used to calculate financial data should also be consistent and comprehensive. Ethical audit ensure that the company's accounts presents a true picture. Now it all depends on the ethical audit. Means ethical audit, which people seldom thinks about, it actually it is ignored. Ethical audit is normally ignored to some extent, right? It helps in bringing accountability and transparency into company's operation, and in tracking the company's progress and identifying the objective it has to achieve. Stakeholders have a right to accurate information on various issues like product safety, environmentally friendly products. See, the stakeholders. Now, why we are working, why we are preparing this financial statements, why we are accountable. Even if you are talking about accountability, corporate social responsibility, answerability. Main answerable hu to kiske taraf hu? Meri accountability hai to for whom I am accountable? It is simply for the stakeholders. Stakeholders have the every right. They have every access to get accurate information. Accurate information on which aspect, like product safety, it is environmentally friendly products and employee relation. Maintaining accurate accounts is an important step for building trust in the organization. Reliable management accounts and financial reports gives a clear picture of the company's position. Ethical issues in mergers and acquisition. Today's most common topic, most observable topic, you must have seen this. Most of the time we are observing, in today's economic environment, it is most of the time we observe mergers, acquisition, and somehow it is creating a dominance in the market. That is why we have Competition Act 2002. So this dominance is being created on the competition, or CCI have observed that most of the dominance in the market, we have removed this MRTP Act, that is Monopolies, Restrictive and Trade Practices. From that, it now becomes Competition Act 2002, amended in 2007. So here in the Competition Act 2002, you will find a segment called Dominance, Abuse of Dominance. So that means you have a dominance market share, which most of the time companies are getting through mergers and acquisition. Companies ke jo dominance position hai, wo kaise aayegi? Simply main aur tum, chalo dono mil jate hain aur teesre party ko jo hai usko competition se hi out kar dete hain. So there are various issues, ethical issues that we will find in mergers and acquisition. In today's economic environment, companies often have to take decisions concerning acquisition or merger. The job of the management is to maximize shareholder value, and in most cases, using mergers and acquisition can help a company to develop a competitive advantage and thereby increase shareholder value. Normally, what we means the job of management ka main kaam kya hota hai? To focus on increase the shareholder value, shareholder maximization of shareholders' wealth, maximization of shareholders' return. This is the most of the time the importance, or this is the job of the management. Fine, shareholders value. Now, in this case, in most cases, using mergers and acquisition, most of the time, it has been observed that mergers and acquisitions are used, and it is mainly used to develop a competitive advantage. Now, definitely, this competitive advantage will create a competitive edge. This competitive advantage is for increasing the shareholder wealth. This competitive advantage is therefore going to give an edge and increases the shareholders' wealth. Fine. It will increase the shareholders' value. Now, at the same time, mergers and acquisitions, buyouts and takeovers present several ethical challenges. Definitely, nothing will come only with advantages. There are disadvantages involved as well. The changes brought about by takeovers and mergers should be handled in such a manner as to protect all the interests of the stakeholders and the shareholders. See, any changes, whatever we means due to mergers, like A and B, they are merged together to form another company called C. Now, in between this merger, that is A and B, we have to take, I mean, it should be handled very carefully in a manner that it will protect the interest of the stakeholders and the shareholders of the organization. Means everyone is important. The stakeholders and the shareholder, they are very important. Displaced or disguised employees whose personal interests are harmed usually criticize takeover. So normally when we are finding few people are normally left out or they are not considered so important, sometimes they are left or something like that, normally criticize takeover. All such criticisms are not legitimate since the purpose of business is maximizing owner value. It has to adopt suitable methods by which organization can derive profits in the long term. So normally the company's aim, the objective of the company is to sustain in the long run and to maximization of the stock shareholders value simply. So it can take any legitimate method. Definitely it has to take any legitimate method. To avoid such protest, a company should have a clear target which can help in bringing realistic expectation to the stakeholders, the required information and an idea of the likely future of the company. Fine. One more charge that is levied, that the takeover involves breach of trust as they transfer wealth to the shareholders by isolating implicit contracts with other stakeholders. See, sometimes there are implicit charges. Means when companies usually adopt, means jab companies merger ya acquisition karte hai na, to sometime a charge is being given. Bahut sare log isko ek tarike se criticize karte hain that jab bhi takeovers hota hai, ek company dusre ko takeover kare, then there are certain breach of trust. बहुत सारे विश्वासघात जिसको बोलते हैं ब्रेच ऑफ ट्रस्ट एज दे ट्रांसफर वेल्थ टू शेयर होल्डर्स बाय आइसोलेटिंग इंप्लिसिट कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स विद अदर स्टेक होल्डर. तो क्या हो रहा है, मैं किसी और के संग नया एक रिलेशन बना रही हूँ, एक कंपनी वाइज मैं बता रही हूँ, मैं एक कंपनी हूँ, मेरी दूसरे के संग रिलेशन एक बन रही है, नया रिलेशन बन रहा है, नया कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स मैं फॉर्म कर रही हूँ इन ऑर्डर टू मैक्सिमाइज प्रॉफिट डेफिनेटली. तो पुराना जो है वो छूटता जा रहा है धीरे धीरे, ठीक है. It implies that a supplier or an employee who expects security for their work can ignore during takeovers. Normally dekha jata hai, jo bhi supplier hai ya employee who expects security for their work, jo security ko lekar kaam karna chahte hai, because normally humne bhi dekha, practically we have observed that people who are target oriented, who are working well, who are achieving their targets consistently, they are consistent performers are only kept whenever there is a change in any organization. Jab bhi koi change hoga na, change management mein, so normally kuch na कुछ लोग रह ही जाते हैं. तो हम लोग जो चल रहे हैं विद द फ्लो, जो काम कर रहे हैं उसको लेते चलते हैं, और जो सिक्योरिटी के लिए बैठे हुए हैं उनको दे आर लेफ्ट ओवर. द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन दैट टेक्स ओवर कैन लुक आउट फॉर अदर suppliers or employees can be let off. Hence, breach of trust is a grave problem as it deprives trust between stakeholders and the business. So, breach of trust is one such important. Thus, for the stakeholders to going in for takeover or merger, each group involved must agree to respect certain contracts or promises. So, whenever there is a takeover, then the company who are entering into this merger, takeover or anything as such, they must respect the certain dignity of other parties. Fine. If a firm promises performance related bonuses for employee and the company that acquires it does not take into account this contract or promises, then it would be unethical and employee would feel demotivated and would not perform as expected. This would result in poor work performance. when the management encourages having a certain expectation among the workers which is not in a position to fulfill, then it could lead to breach of trust. See, sometimes management encourages certain expectation among the workers. It created an expectation that yes, during this takeovers or during this merger, we will provide you this, this, this. Ye sare kuch promises kar dete which they are not able to fulfill. So it definitely it will lead to a breach of trust. Sometimes workers expect high job security or regular pay hikes that are unrelated to productivity, while suppliers are led to believe that they will serve the company forever regardless of the competitive environment. These expectations are not always fulfilled. So normally we have observed that during a takeover or during this type of change in management, the suppliers or the employees are left over. The result in the above cases is dissatisfaction. To avoid this, management must follow procedures and policies in financial transaction, and this must be communicated to the employee. That means in order to avoid this dissatisfaction, means once the employees and the means if the employees plus your suppliers are let back, or we can say they are removed, whatever, they are dissatisfied. So in order to remove them, whenever actually we have discussed about the change management strategy and how to come up with this resistance to change. Normally there's always a resistance from the internal side for change. Change hoga na to resistance bhi aayegi. To resistance ko kam karne ke liye you should always create a proper policies. Aapke paas ek proper procedures hona chahiye regarding the problems ya jo bhi hai aapke financial aspect se hi hone wali hai. So procedures and policies in financial transaction, and this must be properly communicated. Communication of this is very important. During a change, this communication, education, participation, these are few most important strategies that any company, that every company should actually follow. Aap aise hi change nahi kar sakte ho. Change management ke liye bahut zyada zaruri hai, theek hai? If impractical obligations are abandoned after an acquisition, then the change is not unethical. See, agar kuch impractical obligation hai, then usko to fulfill karna is not possible. However, the management of the target should provide compensation when necessary to those who are affected by the decision. But jisko affect hua hai by this decision, unko definitely hume kuch pay off karna chahiye. When one company acquires another company, it must carefully analyze the problems confronting the company it is taking over. Kya na, main agar kisi main acquiring company, I'm taking over some company, a target company, then I should understand ki bhai jo main whichever company I'm taking over, there are certain problems. Jab change hogi ek management style mein, means it will be taken up by someone else, to taking over mein kuch na kuch problem hogi, usko us issues ko practically solve karne ki zarurat hai. Some of the specific aspects that it must take into consideration regarding the expectation of the stakeholders of the acquired company are the intensity of the expectation, how long and how strong were the expectation. First, intensity kya hai expectation ki? Matlab kitni expectation hai, how strong were their expectation, what is the replacement of this expectation, replacement kya hai, kisi ko naukri chahiye. किसी को मतलब इतने लाख रुपए चाहिए, किसी को एक सिक्योरिटी टारगेट चाहिए, सो रिप्लेसमेंट, उसके रिप्लेसमेंट क्या है एक्सपेक्टेशन के. द फ्यूचर इकोनॉमिक इंपैक्ट दैट अ कंपनी कैन हैव बाय रिजेक्टिंग सच एक्सपेक्टेशन एज द वर्कर्स मे नॉट परफॉर्म एज एक्सपेक्टेड. क्या होता है ना, ये इम्प्लॉई मोटिवेशन जो है, ये एक बार अगर नहीं रहा आपके संग एम्प्लॉय लॉयल्टी और एम्प्लॉय मोटिवेशन, देन इन फ्यूचर इन लॉन्ग रन यू माइट फाइंड सम ट्रबल विद द मैनेजिंग द कंपनी. दैट इज वाई, क्योंकि एक बार ही शुरू में ही अगर आपके ऊपर विश्वास हट गया ना लोगों का, आपके एम्प्लॉयज का, तो फिर वो कभी नहीं आएगा. आप अभी टेक ओवर कर रहे हो मेरी कंपनी को, और मेरी कंपनी का जो स्टाफ है उनका विश्वास आपके ऊपर से हट गया, तो फिर वो दोबारा कभी भी नहीं आने वाला. सो इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट वी हैव टू कंसिडर कि व्हाट कैन बी द रिप्लेसमेंट ऑप्शन. हम जितना कर सकते हैं पूरी वो पूर्ति करें, नहीं कर सकते हैं देन वो भी क्लियरली कम्युनिकेट करें. क्योंकि अगर हम उसको बीच में लटका के छोड़ दिए या ऐसे ही छोड़ दिया, मैंने रिजेक्ट कर दिया उसको, तो फ्यूचर इम्पैक्ट होगा एम्प्लॉय डीमोटिवेशन, एंड देन द इम्पैक्ट विल बी ऑन द लोअर एंड डाउन ऑफ द प्रोडक्टिविटी. ऑफकोर्स the impact of such a situation on the future stakeholders. While an acquirer plans to console aggrieved stakeholders by compensating them, it has to make it clear that it is fulfilling inappropriate commitments made by previous management. See, देखो, when an acquirer plans to console aggrieved stakeholder, क्या होता है ना, कभी कभी जो acquirer, मैं जैसे acquire कर रही हूँ target company को, मैं plan कर रही हूँ कि भाई दे सबको शांतोना दूंगी, aggrieved stakeholder, जो भी aggrieved stakeholder है उनको compensate करके, then it has to make it clear that it is fulfilling inappropriate commitment made by the previous management. The message should be communicated in an unambiguous manner, otherwise it may lead to more अनरियलिस्टिक एक्सपेक्टेशन. अब ये जैसे मैं अगर आपके कोई मनमानी जिद मान रही हूँ या कोई गलत जिद को मान रही हूँ बिकॉज प्रीवियसली किसी ने, मतलब प्रीवियस मैनेजमेंट ने आपको कमिट की थी या आपको प्रॉमिस की थी, अब प्रॉमिस को तोड़ देने से तो एक डीमोटिवेशन आ जाएगा, पर मैं अगर आपका कोई जिद को फुलफिल कर रही हूँ देन आई शुड एक्सप्लेन यू इन दिस इन एन अनएम्बिजियस मैनर. क्या होता है ना, कभी कभी डायरेक्टली अगर आप कन्वे करने जाओगे, मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम इन एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन वी हैव टू कम्युनिकेट इफेक्टिवली, efficiently, everything needs to be communicated properly. हमें communication का एक balance रखना है, कितना communicate करना है, क्या communicate करना है, we should be very clear about communicating terms, communicating words. हम लोग इसको semantic barriers भी बोलते हैं. In communication, we also use the term that is semantic barrier. मतलब created barrier. मैं कुछ ऐसी चीजें बता रही हूँ जो आपको समझ में भी आ रहा है बट आपको बुरा भी नहीं लग रहा है, पॉजिटिव नो जैसे होता है ना उसी तरह का. तो इट हैज टू बी कन्वेड, मतलब चेंज मैनेजमेंट में, इसलिए हम लोग स्ट्रैटेजिक मैनेजमेंट में स्ट्रैटेजिक कम्युनिकेशन मैनेजमेंट बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. दिस इज अ स्पेसिफिक थिंग, ये जो स्ट्रैटेजिक कम्युनिकेशन है, दिस इज स्पेसिफिक टॉपिक विच वी यूजली टॉट टू द सीनियर मैनेजमेंट, सीनियर एग्जीक्यूटिव, जो जनरल, मतलब आपके जनरल मैनेजर लेवल से ऊपर जो जाते हैं ना, उनको ये चीजें जानने की जरूरत है. नॉर्मली वो पहुंच ही नहीं पाएंगे, दे कैन नॉट रीच टू दैट लेवल इफ दे डोंट नो हाउ टू इफेक्टिवली कम्युनिकेट इन एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इन अ स्ट्रैटेजिक मैनर. सो ये भी वही हुआ, आप बता भी रहे हो और नहीं भी बता रहे हो. ठीक है, इट्स सिंपली लाइक मेरी मम्मी ने आज एक मिठाई बनाई है, लड्डू, अजवाइन का लड्डू. ठीक है, उसमें गुड़ भी है पर वो मीठा नहीं है, इट्स वेरी डेंजरस. सो इट्स सिंपली एकदम स्ट्रैटेजिक मैनेजमेंट वाला लड्डू बनाया है मेरा मम्मी ने. तो